Hey guys, welcome back to Magic TV. My name's Craig. It is 9 o'clock on a Tuesday, which means it's time for a Matt or a Craig test. And today, it's a Craig test. How you doing? You well?
I think so. Yeah, nobody else in the office is.
No, everyone's ill.
Everyone's all snotty and gross, so I'm trying to stay away from everyone.
But you're sitting next to me and I've been snotty and gross.
True. And so is he.
Yeah, everyone is.
And now I'm in a very unventilated room.
Yeah.
It's basically just...
It's a death trap.
Full of... manky off bacteria now.
Yep, don't worry about it. It's nice to see that you're cheery as normal. Anyway, we're back with a Craig test this time. Matt is going to try and fool me with the trick. I will tell you, you're not going to fool me.
Oh no.
For a couple of different reasons, one of which is about 6 months ago, me and Ryan reviewed
this trick.
You
did a review on it, I know.
Yeah.
I know, after you'd given it to me.
Did you watch the review?
No.
Ryland hated this.
I see you enough.
Ryland hated this.
Why?
Ryland hated this, and I wasn't too keen on it.
Why?
So I'm hoping that you can change my mind.
What did Ryland give it?
I think it was like minus a bazillion or something.
Shit. I mean, I don't understand his marking system, but that doesn't sound good.
No, that's not good at all. I was worried that Dan Harlan was going to come and beat him up.
I don't think Dan Harlan would beat him up. Dan Harlan's too nice.
I don't know. He's got a checkered past.
Well, he comes across with, I don't really know the guy, but
you haven't heard about the cash register thing?
Cash, what did he rob a bank?
A shop.
He robbed a shop.
He's over it now. I interviewed him and he was in his dark days. He had dark days, but I mean, he is an incredible creator of magic. When I was on the Wizard Pro Review,
if he's taking the piss or not.
No. So when he, many, many years ago, he did rob a till out of a shop. And he was running out of the shop and his trousers fell around his ankles and he knocked himself out on the cash register. Not joking.
You've got to be.
No,
might Google that.
No. Look, it was I interviewed him on Magic TV and we openly talked about it. And you know, he talked about how it wasn't a good period of time for him.
Clearly not. I don't think anybody who's attempting to rob a shop, their trousers fall down and then they knock themselves out.
What I felt really bad about is on the Wizard Product Review, we used to do some really crazy stuff, me and David Penn, and we parodied it. And I went running into World Magic Shop and stole the cash register and had my trousers fall around my ankles and pretended to knock myself out.
So someone who had a really shitty time.
Yeah.
And then you made a video of it to take piss on the internet.
Yeah. It's kind of what I did back then. I was very immature. But now I'm grown up and sensible. Yeah, now I'm totally grown up and sensible.
Yeah, totally.
And I'm all about being mature. Mature is what I'm at.
Mature is what I'm at.
Yep. I'm down.
Okay, not only is that grammatically incorrect.
What's a grammatically?
Grammatically. Is that a word, isn't it? Grammatically?
No, it's grammatically. Yes. If you're going to criticize someone about their pronunciation, how about you fucking
getting that specific word wrong is kind of the definition of irony, isn't it?
Yes, it really is. Those people who live in glass houses shouldn't throw stones.
It is grammatically, isn't it?
Yes, yeah. Not grammacky.
What did I say?
Grammackily.
Grammackily?
It wasn't a word, was it?
No,
it's not a word.
I should probably shut up.
Yeah. You're a fucking idiot, but we love you. Right, okay. So with that being said, Dan Harlan is a genius. Ryland didn't like this. I was ambivalent towards it. I'm happy to have my mind changed. Change my mind.
I'd just like to point out that he's wearing leather pants. He's wearing leather pants and trousers.
And he's squeaking his little butt off.
Who comes and works in an office dressed like...
Yeah. You know.
A biker?
Look at me. I'm always well-dressed and presentable when I'm in the office. What? Who are you? Walking around like you're the Terminator.
Something like that. Do you want to see this trick then, Omar?
Yeah, of course I do.
Okay, cool. So what we're going to do is use this necklace.
Yes. Are they your anal beads?
They are not.
Okay. You keep those at home.
They're way bigger than this. So I'm going to use them to demonstrate the power of positive thinking. So So it's got nothing to do with the beads,
no.
To be fair. These are just going to be used as a demonstration of it. Okay. So if you look at people like Lewis Hamilton,
yes,
super famous.
Very famous.
All of his social media, his posts, all that kind of stuff. It's all about PMA, positive mental attitude, positive thinking. If you think it and you believe it, it can happen. You can make anything happen.
If your mind can conceive, the body can achieve.
Exactly. You can make anything happen with a positive outlook on life. Okay? And people like Kevin Hart and Mark Wahlberg and The Rock and all these guys, they're all the same. Everything's about positive mental attitude. It's about making things happen. And there's got to be something in it because all of those guys are mega rich. Okay?
Yeah, they are.
Well, so there's got to be something in that.
But they don't have their own set of anal beads.
You don't know that.
Well, good point. I've never seen their anal beads.
I mean, I can't imagine they'd put them on TikTok.
You never know, they might.
They might just be in a drawer in their bedroom. So what we're going to do is we're going to use these beads as and demonstrate what these guys are talking about.
Okay.
If we're positive, we can make anything happen.
Okay.
Okay, so you can see these beads are on there.
I see the beads.
Yeah.
I see the beads.
Okay, perfect. What I need you to do is put your hand out like this. Perfect. I'm going to put those on to your thumb. And we're just going to rest them like that. Okay. And then what I need you to do is just wrap your hand around all four of the strings. Perfect.
You're feeling sleepy.
Yeah. Just make it so that the strings are at the bottom there.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, you got them?
I've got them.
Okay, perfect. Now you can see that the beads are here, right? And they're not going to be able to go anywhere now.
Yeah, the beads are there.
Because they're being blocked. Yeah, I'm just saying that they're going to be blocked by your...
I'm not letting those beads go anywhere.
You're not letting those beads go anywhere. Okay, perfect. So what we're going to do is, you can see that they're solidly on there, yeah?
Yeah, they are, yeah.
Put your finger just through there for me. Other finger from the underneath. Perfect. And then stretch it out tight so you can see that they're all on there. You got them?
My finger is through and it's stretched out tight.
Exactly. So those beads aren't going to go anywhere now, right?
No, they're not.
Okay. Pass it me back. I just wanted you to have a look at that just to demonstrate what it is. So now what I need you to do is concentrate on those beads. If you've got anything negative in your life at the minute, any negative emotions, negative feelings, anything negative that's in your life, I need you to concentrate. Look at the beads. Concentrate on those beads. Just focus on the beads.
On the beads or the negative thing?
What I need you to do is push all of your negative emotions into these beads.
It's mainly you.
Well, push me into the beads.
I'm pushing.
Okay, so you're focusing all of your negative energy onto those beads.
I'm focusing all my negative energy onto the beads.
Onto those beads. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take that negative energy, we're going to do something impossible with it. And we're going to disconnect it from the rest of your life. So the chain of your life is this string.
Okay.
This is your life, and that's the way that your life is going. These negative things here in the middle, they're blocking that the timeline here. Okay? So we're going to take...
Can I ask you a question? Have you been watching Loki Season 2?
No, I have not.
Are you sure?
I'm positive.
Because you've just basically described the plot of Loki Season 2.
I've never seen Loki Season 1, 2, or any of the other seasons.
Do you even know who Loki is?
I've not a clue.
Really?
No.
Have you seen Loki season?
I have. Yes. Can we get on with the trick?
Hang on. Isn't he basically describing season two of Loki?
He pretty much has.
Oh my God. Right down to the time. Do you work for the TSA?
Who the fuck is this TSA?
The timeline. What is it? Time?
Time variant.
The time variant agency. The
How can that be TSA?
Is it TVA?
TVA.
TVA. The time variant agency. Are you an agent for the TVA?
I don't know who the TVA are.
No, not TVAR, just TVA.
Can we get on with the fucking trick?
Where did the R come from? That's not part of it.
He's my negative energy. All of my negative energy comes out of that.
Right, so we've got a timeline.
This is your timeline.
Are we going to be pruning any branches anytime soon?
No.
Okay.
So you're going to focus all of your negative energy onto these
Can
beads,
I ask a question? You're supposed to be making me feel all like motivated and Lewis Hamilton and if you can achieve it and we're going to get rid of your negative energy. But you're looking a bit stressed yourself. Would you like this to represent your negative energy?
Yes, please.
Okay, keep going. You're doing great. Honestly, I'm loving this. Carry on.
You're the worst spectator on earth. You are the worst spectator.
No, I'm not.
If you were ever in an L&L audience, they would have strung you up out the back and beaten you with rocks. He's a terrible spectator.
I think if I was an L&L audience, I would have slashed my wrists with a billet knife. Carry on.
Just grab the fucking beads.
What happened to all the motivation?
Just grab the fucking beads.
What happened to all the motivation?
I'm done with motivation. You've done the opposite of that. You've sucked all of the motivation out of me. Just grab the fucking beads.
I'm grabbing your beads.
Right. Now, when I say...
Yeah? What's the purpose? Am I taking this negative energy out of my
life?
We're
going to take the negative energy off of your timeline by removing the negative energy.
Okay, but just say that you're going to prune the branches. The you're pruning the branches.
We're going to prune the branches.
That's me! The TVA! Okay, go on, sorry.
Okay, after three.
After three.
Pull that hand that way.
I will.
One, two, three.
Oh, look at that. Wow.
Yep, wow.
You made your anal beads penetrate off. That was very good. Doing great. It's awesome.
Just ruined it.
Ruined it. That was a great presentation. Honestly, I love that.
It may have been an okay presentation up until the point where you just wrote yourself into the script.
I was strong in this. Oh, it was good. It was good. What do you think of it?
I actually like it.
Okay. I actually quite like that presentation. Obviously, you had a bit of a arse of a spectator.
A bit?
Not
you're the worst spectator in the history of magic.
Ask anybody at a convention. I'm a great spectator. You come and show me magic, I'm going to act all really impressed and shit.
Well, why don't you do that with me?
Because it's you. I'm not going to do that with you. Fuck's sake. Okay, let me tell you what me and Ryland specifically didn't like about this, and you can argue the point.
Who performed it to who?
Ryland performed it to me.
Were you such a dick to Ryland?
Never. although he shot me in the head with a Nerf gun.
Good.
Let me tell you our issues with it. So there are a couple of issues. Obviously, this is based on grandmother's anal bead, the grandmother's necklace, right? By TCC, which you've seen
it's
me perform.
It's a similar effect to grandmother's necklace.
You've seen me perform.
Grandma's necklace.
I think grandma's necklace is a better trick. Because I just the thing with grandma's necklace, so you've seen me perform it. When you've got, first of all, the beads are see-through. Mm-hmm. I mean, it looks more like a magic trick, while that looks more like an organic prop. I get that.
Yep.
But I'm not going to be carrying this around and wearing it around my neck. It's not my style. Might be your style, not my style. So I don't have no problem at a gig pulling out a couple of velvet cords and some see-through beads. I have no problem with that at all. Mm-hmm. Because the beads are see-through, it looks more like you're having to be a little bit cozy at times and like, okay, yeah, do that. You're having to direct me around a bit. Whilst with the TCC version, they are obviously on there and you just get them to hold a hand and then boom, it penetrates through.
Yeah.
Second of all, you kind of put those ropes away quite quickly. You were like scrunched them up in your hand. From memory, and it was a few months ago we reviewed it, you can't examine them at the end, can you? Really?
No. The beads, yes. You can just hand them the beads.
Yeah, but the necklacey thing.
Necklacey thing, no, not really. He does it the other way round, and I just wanted to try it. He does it where he takes them off.
I think it's better if you take
them. And then he has the beads. So yeah, he takes the beads off himself and then hands them out, and then I think he just snatches the rope away real quick.
So that was
I tried to do it the other way around, so the beads end up in your hand.
The first issue was the TCC version looked cleaner with the see-through beads and everything and blah, blah, blah. The second version is you can examine the TCC version at the end. You can't examine that. Mm-hmm. The third thing is you can examine everything at the beginning of the TCC version. So you can give one rope out to somebody, one cord out to somebody else.
Yeah.
You can give the beads out to somebody else. But this, from memory, is set in a particular position. It's set up, like you have to have it set in a particular way in order to do this trick. So you can't have it examined at the beginning.
Not fully. No, not you fully. Can't hand it to somebody.
No,
like
exactly.
It's around your neck.
Yeah.
So it's designed as like an EDC.
I totally get that.
It's an EDC that you can wear. So you literally just walk up to somebody and it's on your neck.
And then the last thing that we made the point of is the penetration doesn't look as good with this because you're kind of pulling them off, which is fine. Mm-hmm. But with the TCC one, if you remember, it's in their hand and holding the beads here and you just pull and it penetrates up through their hand and left with the beads in their hand, which is a stronger moment. And it wasn't so much that this was bad. It was more of a case of there's more negatives with this than there are with the TCC version, which leaves you with the one positive, which is this is more organic.
Yeah.
And Ryland's point on this is it may be more organic, but you're not going to wear this as an everyday carry. And I don't know, because I don't remember the tutorial, and he watched it to the point that he learned it. I just paid it lip service.
Mm-hmm.
But his point was the way that it was set up, he wouldn't want to wear this all day because there's a very good chance walking around, the setup would come undone if it was around his neck. which a few people have said on the internet as well, in the, because there's something to do with a bite or something.
And only if the bead, the middle bead stays where it is, it's going to stay there all day.
Yeah, but if the bead, middle bead didn't,
if
or
the
you knocked
if the
it
middle, if the middle bead moved, you'd be in trouble.
Yeah. So his point was, you wouldn't want to have it on all day.
No, you wouldn't have it on all day, but you could have it on which at mean, a gig.
Yeah, but that's the point. This is designed. That was Ryland's point. His point was, the main advantage of this is to wear it as an EDC.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not that practical as an EDC, because in order to wear it to do it, to have it set up to do the trick, you are going to stand a risk at some point of it being knocked or something, not actually stay on your... So, and also, the other thing about it as an EDC is it, there's a bit of a reset from memory. You can't
is a reset, yeah.
Yeah, you have to go somewhere and reset it in order to...
It's a really quick reset.
But it's still a reset.
But yeah, yeah,
like you would like if you were at a gig, you'd have to go somewhere out the way.
Yeah.
To reset it.
Because the beads are coming off of the string.
Yeah.
So you've got to then put them back on.
Yeah. Well, but with the TCC thing, the beads come off the string and you immediately show it to people and put it back in your pocket and you reset ready to go again.
Yeah, because you do the whole process in front of the
expect.
Yeah.
So it wasn't so much as that was bad, it was just as much of you have to compare it against TCC's version. And you know, I mean, this is Penguin. I work with Penguin. I'd rather be honest than you know, and also I love Dan Harlan. But there were a lot of negatives with this. And the one positive is that it's an EDC, but it's not really an EDC because you wouldn't want to wear this all day in the hope that you're going to show somebody the trick at some point.
Yeah.
Having said that, I very much liked the presentation that you did to me. It felt better than I remember Ryland doing it to. Maybe you did it better than Ryland, I don't know. But it felt, maybe it's because you pulled them off, I don't know. But that moment, it felt like the beads were on the cord. When Ryland did it to me, it didn't feel like the beads were on the cord. And when you watch the trailer, it doesn't look very magical when he's pulling the beads off. It doesn't look that great, which was another problem compared to TCC's version.
Okay.
But I don't know. I mean, what do you think? I mean, this is the sort of thing that you would wear. Would you do this at a gig?
I'd do it at a gig, yeah. It's the kind of thing you'd only really be able to do once without having to then run off and reset it and then... But I like the best thing about this is the routine that he's come up with. The kind of getting rid of the negative energy, and he gets people to breathe out. And as they breathe out, he then takes the beads off of the string. I wanted to try it the other way and see what it would be like. That's the first time that I've done it on my own at home a bunch of times to try and get it right. But like, that's the first time I've done it with a spectator. So I just thought it'd be cool to try and get you to take the beads off and just see what
it
looked like.
It absolutely works.
It does. I just didn't realise until afterwards you have to grab the string really quickly. but yeah, I think I like the idea, because at that point the focus is going to be on the beads anyway. So it's going to give you a second to kind of get the strings out of the way. But yeah, I do.
See, I think that they'd want to examine those strings. If some beads have gone through strings... I know that when I do the TCC version, after I've had it penetrate through, they want to look at the cords.
Well, you can kind of... I suppose you could. I don't know, you'd have to work it out. But, I mean, if you could just ball them up and then hand them to somebody, and then that's absolutely fine. Because all you're doing is...
Oh, don't give anything away.
I'm not trying... I'm not... I don't think you can give anything away. But, you could still give them out.
Okay.
You can still give them out to people.
Okay.
They're literally just pieces of string with necklace clasps on them.
Okay.
So you could hand them out.
All right, okay. You think you can?
I think so.
So here's the question. Would you do this?
I like it. As far as, like, that's the kind of thing where if you're doing that in a gigging situation, it's going to draw attention. And then the fact that you do it, and then somebody goes... Because he's got a couple of people, like spectators, that are doing the trailer where they go, oh my God, you don't know how much I needed that today. That's like really helped me and thank you. And then the person that he does it in the tutorial video, there's a woman there that just goes, I do feel better after that now. I really needed that today. Wow. You know what I mean? So it's got a kind of, the way that he presents it is really good. It's got a really impactful presentation. And I think if you were doing that to a group of people and then someone went, oh, God, yeah, I feel better now, actually. Like, I really needed that today. And someone goes, oh, can you do that to me? And you go, yeah, I'll be back in 5 minutes. Do you know what I mean? That's going to be a bit like, that you've got to then go away and then, oh, I'm back. Do you want to try the necklace thing now? Is a little bit.
Yeah.
As in a gigging situation, you could do with being able to go, yeah, of course, absolutely. And then just doing it. Whereas with that, you can't.
Although you could go into something else instead.
You could go into somebody else, but if somebody's really liked what you've just done and they go, can you do me? It's rude to just go, well, I can, but just let me do some more tricks here with these people first, and then I'm going to have to go to the bathroom, and then I'll come back and do it. Do you know what I mean? You're not making that person feel very special. If somebody specifically requests you to do something at a gig, you've got to be able to just do it, I think.
Yeah, I agree with
that. To make that
person. So really, you're not going to do it then?
It depends on the situation. Like, if I was in a situation at a gig where I know, like, I'm very rarely at a gig where it's just one-on-one with someone. That just doesn't, especially the last couple of months, that just doesn't happen. You're always performing to, like, 10 people at a time. If I'm in a position where I feel like I could get away with doing it just once, I think it's really strong and I would do it. Okay. If it was like you were
a also, I know you've never worked restaurants, but just a thought here. With restaurants, it's kind of very chilled. If you've got a residency and you're there every week, normally, like when I used to do restaurants, I'd do a table. It wouldn't be a hustle to go to the next table straight away. I'd go back to the bar, have a drink, run to the loo, you know. And, so you could easily find time to reset if you were working a restaurant.
Or
so
if you've got restaurant workers, a special person at an event, like if it's a 40th birthday party, you could do it to the birthday person. Do you know what I mean? Where you didn't have to, because I've got something special for you. Mm. If you could get away with doing that, then great. But yeah, I mean, I would do it at a gig in the right situation.
Okay. And would you use it as an everyday carry?
Well, no, because like you said, you can't really, because there's a very strong possibility that all the beads would just fall off.
That would be terrible.
Which wouldn't be great. No. So I think as a... The idea of... I understand why he's calling it an everyday carry. Because if you walk into a bar and you're gigging in a bar and you've got an actual gig that you're booked to pay for, you could walk in with it round your neck and you wouldn't ever have to touch it. You could just walk out with having never done it if you wanted to. It will quite happily sit around there and it looks like an everyday carry. It looks like a necklace. So I understand what he means by, you know, it's the ultimate everyday carry because... It's just a necklace. And if nobody knew, then that's all it is.
Yeah.
But an everyday carry, it depends on your definition of an everyday carry. An everyday carry for a professional magician that's going out to gigs, yes, it is an everyday carry. For an everyday carry, meaning somebody that is literally going to walk around with it around their neck every waking moment of every day, then no, you probably couldn't.
Okay. So what are you giving it?
I really like the routine that he does, and I think it could be, if you sell it in the right way, I think it could be really impactful. But it is kind of like a one shot and you're done. I'm gonna give it 80%.
80%? That's not bad.
Like, not bad. I would do it, but it's not perfect for a worker.
80%? 80%? That's not bad. You're getting really good at this reviewing thing. Good job.
People like... as a worker, that's my review. For somebody that's...
A year ago, if you could go back in time, if you could find a way, would you turn around to...
Is that even a song?
If I could turn back time.
Oh, that's a song.
Yeah. If I could find a way...
Please don't sing.
I'd take back those words that hurt you, and you'd stay... If I could reach the stars.
Can you just say what you were going
to
say?
I'd give them all to you.
Fuck me.
No thanks. Use your anal beads. What was I saying? A year ago, if I could go back in time, a year ago to when little Matt was on the Matrimentary season one, getting ridiculed by doing party dances in Drayton Manor, and I said to you, in a year's time, Matthew Cluley, you'll be sitting there on Magic TV reviewing products and talking about them from a worker's point of view. You wouldn't believe me. Look how far you've come. It's awesome.
How long has this video been going on for now?
Too long.
Too long.
Okay.
We should wrap it up. 80% from Matt.
Yeah. No. You have reviewed it, so what would your review be now? What did he give it back in before?
How's he meant to know?
Do you know how many reviews we do?
I can't remember. I'm giving it 50%. I'm never going to do it. It's good. Look, I liked the performance that you did on me as a spectator.
Which is based on the performance that he does.
Yeah, as a spectator, I would enjoy it. It's just it's got too many drawbacks for me to do it, and I prefer TCC's thing. So 50%. It's good, but just not mine sort of thing. You do it. It's good. You have it. Thanks very much for joining me, Matt, on another Craig Test. We really appreciate you being here. Matt's got to go back and sell shit now for a few minutes before
we're going home in a minute.
We'll see you again soon. Thanks very much. Say bye, Matt. Come on, actually say bye this time. Go on, say bye. Don't be grumpy pants. Go say bye.
It's like super cringy.
Just say bye. Fucking say bye.
Bye.
Not to me, to them.
It's like super cringy.
It's called a wrap up. You do it on YouTube. My name's Matt Cluley, and this is the map test.
Yeah, people do it all the time. They just do it less cringy than you.
So you show me how it's done properly, Mr. Actor.
No, I don't.
Do it. Do me a wrap-up.
No, because it's going to be cringy now.
Do me a wrap-up. Get the camera right in on Matt's face. Do me the wrap-up.
I don't want to do
it. There's the camera. Do a wrap-up. Do a wrap-up. Do a wrap-up. Wrap it up.
You wrap it up.
Thanks very much for watching.
No, not...
Oh. What? You told me to wrap it up? Wrap it up.
Bye.
We'll see you again soon. Thanks very much for watching. I'm Craig. He's Matt. We'll be back again next week with another Matt Craig test. Bye, everyone. Come on, wrap it up properly.
Bye.
That's the best you can get.